Hello, my friends. This is Wolfgang, and welcome to my Tools for Ascension. This time we will be doing a guided meditation on how to contact your inner shaman. We will be contacting your inner shaman. And I want to thank all my subscribers for waiting so patiently. It has been taken some time, but I hope the quality will be a bit better from now on. So first of all, let's just talk about guided meditation. Normal guided meditation or hypnosis enables so-called normal people to see extraordinary things, to get into your subconscious and even experience what is so-called the supernatural realms. And of course, you know, there are certain principles, you know, making this possible. And for instance, you know, in the yogic system, the yogi perfects his body through asanas, you know, through stretching and sitting positions over many years, where he releases stress from the body and stress from the spine, and learn how to completely relax his body. And then of course he also will train his mind through meditation to focus. And then of course if he has the right teacher, he will learn how to use how to move and use his life airs. You know, in the Hindu system it's called pranas. You know, and commonly it's known as chi, ki, vril, you know, or old. These are just some names from different paradigms. So through the progressive relaxation, you know, that will be the beginning of our guided meditation, we will achieve artificially a similar state without having to go through years and years of austerities. And so it is very important that you really are at a quiet place, that you really are, you know, willingly and happily relax yourself, you know, give it your best, because the deeper you are relaxed, your body is relaxed, the better the results will be. It's very similar to a flotation device, you know, where all external stimuli are taken away, and normally, you know, you could say the processing power of the mind, that's generally dedicated to a lot of visual, audio, and tactile stimuli that coming through the body, you know, that can be used somewhere else. And also with the guided meditation, there are different people have different results. I mean, over my lifetime so far, I have seen people that have vision, can see an aura, can talk to ghosts and spirits and God beings, higher dimensional beings, with their eyes open. And other people on the other end of the spectrum, you know, have a very hard time. They have to go through very, very deep relaxation, to very, very deep letting go. And, you know, things may not flow so easily. And, of course, probably we are all somewhere on the spectrum. These kind of guided meditations that are on a cookie-cutter format probably are most successful, you know, with those that have a predisposition, that are talented, that can see things with their eyes open, or you know, that have some yogic practices already. If you know, some people that are not successful, generally the causes are they cannot let go. Maybe they were in a hostile environment or in a past life. They have been abused by a shaman or had bad experiences as a priestess. You know, or just straight survival issues, you know, have been betrayed maybe. There can be a lot of reason. Also a hyperactive mind can be a trap, you know, where, oh, you know, something and an interesting vision comes up, and then, oof, you know, the person goes into the mind and says, oh, this is interesting, I hope I'm not making this up, and could this be hereditary, or could this be this or that, and then, boof, you know, we are out of the direct experiences back to the mental plane, which is where we normally reside in our everyday consciousness. Actually, we should be residing in our heart, not on our mental plane. But that's, I talk about that in another video. So, also, narrow-mindedness, can inhibit you. You know, if you think that any type of meditation or hypnosis is a tool of the devil, and Jesus Christ is going to hate you, God is going to hate you, this is the biggest insult towards divinity you can do, well, you know, it's probably not going to work for you, though I strongly work with divinity, and I think they want you to do anything you can, you know, to get in touch with them. A fear of letting go, or just plain materialism, you know, thinking this is all a fictition of the mind, these are all just different brain states or chemical brain soup states you experience, and you're basically hallucinating, some kind of story together, maybe self-importance and ego, have a big role in this, and that's why we have maybe 2,000 Cleopatras from past life regression that's always being claimed. Well, you probably will not have good results either. So this is really for the people, that already on the level, that have no problem, that have been meditating, for years and years, that are gifted or waking up, this is for you. Okay. And right now, just, go into a very comfortable position, either in a big, nice grandfather chair, leaning back, or just laying down, very, very comfortable. Make sure there are no pets around, because they're going to be all over you once you start vibrating with the love vibration. And first of all, we will be invoking protection. You can invoke anybody you want that you trust. I trust Archangel Michael to please make sure that we're guided and protected, and that everything we're doing here and any effect I'm having on anybody else here is only going to be for the highest good, in divine harmony with the most benevolent outcomes. That is my disclaimer, because I do not know what is best for anybody. You know, as humans, we have only limited access to information. So, and I also invite your high selves, my high selves, and Mother Earth, and all the beings that support you, your totem animals, your spirit guides, your ancestors, everybody that's from the light, that's from love, and that is authorized by your high self. We invite those. And the purpose of this session is to get you in touch with your inner shaman, which could be an external teacher that you had maybe in a past life, or that you qualified for in this life, or it could be a shaman that you were yourself in a past life. Many healers have been shamans, many yogis, meditators have been shamans in past lives, so it would be very, very easy to interface with those. And we ask that, of course, this will only happen, if this is part of your mission. Okay? And now we do a progressive relaxation. First of all, we ask that divine river, like Mother Ganges, every river is in a way divine, will be flowing over us and relaxing us. And, you know, this divine river enters us at the crown and just flows into our skull and relaxes our skull. The scalp is relaxing and we smile. Ah, and this feels so good. And now this relaxing energy flows into our forehead. And we become aware of all the tension in our forehead and let go of it. And then it flows into the ring muscles in our eye sockets and eyelids, and we become aware of all the tension we're holding there and let go of it. And now it's flowing over into the cheek muscles, into the jaw muscles. And just like a waterfall, all the tension just flows out of it into the earth. Oh, this feels so good. And gradually, as your jaw muscles relax, all this beautiful relaxation energy flows into the ring muscle of your mouth. And relax, and just let go. Release all the tension and your lips become fluffy. Relaxed. And now the relaxing power flows into your throat, releasing any restrictions that are there on the gross as well as physical level. It seems to be blooming in a way. And now gradually that relaxing power moves into your chest area, relaxing all those muscles in the chest area, between the ribs. And you might feel as if a heavy burden is being lifted off your shoulders and off your chest. It's just floating up and away. And now gradually that relaxing power moves into your tummy area. There's so much turmoil with so many of us, and now it's just like a big lake where the water seems to calm. And everything gradually turns calm in your intestinal area. And any tension just flows into the earth to be recycled. And now the relaxing power moves into your groin area, taking away all the tension away from there, removing any cordings that shouldn't be there, and removing any blocks there. And make this nice and grounded, so there's a nice, strong, calm energy there, especially at the coccyx. And now this relaxing energy moves into your thighs, and your thighs just seem to be melting into the ground. And into your knees, and there feel vibrant as they're getting filled with this beautiful nourishing energy. And now it moves into your calves. And there's so much tension there that you become aware of. And now it's moving into your feet, into your heels, to all the small bones, all the way into your toes. It's just all this tension is flowing out, and your feet become kind of radiant again. And while this relaxing power just flows to the front part of your body and keeps cleansing and relaxing it, now another stream comes again to the top of your head, and it's flowing into your neck. and into your upper shoulder area. And oh, does it feel good to let go of that tension there? And now it's moving down the spine, vertebra by vertebra, removing any tension there, relaxing it, aligning the energy down, 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 into the pelvic area. And there are a lot of muscles that are quite stressed, so now it's just flowing in there and nourishing and relaxing those glute muscles there. Oh. And it's relaxing your whole pelvic area. And flowing again out your feet through the legs, of course. And now a third stream of relaxing power moves in the top of the head, into the neck, into the upper shoulders, into your arms. The upper arms. You become aware of any tension you're holding there. The arms just seem to be sinking into the ground till you cannot feel them anymore. Then your lower arms. All that tension that is being held, it just flows out. All those blockages in your wrist, you're just getting dissolved. And now your cheek flows freely into your fingers and clears on any blockages there. And now your hands feel more like baseball gloves, you know, there's a lot of chi flowing out, so nice. Now as your body relax, we will go into an even deeper state into our mind. And we just imagine that in our heart there's an elevator door, and we step into this elevator and press the all the way down button. And now the elevator goes down, down, down with us. And every time we go more down, we relax three times more and progress three times more into our subconscious that knows everything. And we go deeper down, 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 letting go of outmoded belief system, deeper down, down, down. Letting go of all pain and conditionings that don't help us anymore. And deeper down, 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 down. Deeper down, 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 down. And now, gradually the elevator stops and you step out and you come onto a beautiful beach. You can feel the hot sand under your feet. Oh, and the sunlight on your skin, and you hear some seagulls and smell the ocean breeze, and you look around your palms, and this beautiful clean white beach and blue ocean with waves rolling onto the beach. It's like one of your most beautiful times in your life. It's very, very nice. You're so happy. And now you just lay down onto the beach and you feel the crystalline energy from the sun-charged sand nourishing your body. And we ask that the cosmic Christ, all those beings that love unconditionally, surround you with a cloud of love. And now this cloud gradually lifts you up, bringing you into your higher mind, into your spiritual mind, that is beyond space and time, to meet your shaman. And you float high and high and higher and higher, And the higher you flow, the more etheric you become, the more you expand, becoming one with your spiritual, non-corporal side. And you float higher and higher and higher. And it feels so good to expand and feel light. And still you float higher and higher and higher. And you can feel the bliss of the heavenly realms. And you feel so good. And now this cloud gradually stops and it turns into this iridescent bubble, which is your inner sanctuary. And it protects you, it nourishes you, and you're just like floating on it like an invisible throne. And now we invite what is called your inner shaman. We ask for his or her presence now. Amen. And some of you may see a person, some of you may feel a presence, some of you may see a light, and some of you may not experience anything. And so we ask that any obstacles that are there to have in full communication with your internal shaman, please find or remove on, clear on, continue to finish. Amen. And now we ask for the inner shaman again, and we smile, and we ask the inner shaman to please show us, first of all, if they are a part of our own soul, you know, like a parallel self that lived in another time or in another dimension, or is it an old teacher? Another human being, maybe from past lives or parallel time, another being that is our teacher, an external being. So we just ask a simple question, are you a part of me, yes or no? And whatever pops into your mind, just take this as the answer, don't judge it. And then also ask, you know, are you an external teacher to me, yes or no? And whatever pops into your mind, take this as the answer, and you can ask three times that same question. Just go into neutral. You know, do not have any expectation, but do not filter out anything that pops into your mind. Okay, and now we ask this being if he or she has been having an effect in our life already, and if it has so, to please show us through memories, and you certain scenes may just pop up in your mind. And now ask this being, you know, how best for your time of your evolution at this time it can work with you or through you. And maybe you see something or feel something or have some memories of some healing techniques. And I hope you see or experience something. And if you are a healer already, you know, or maybe you know somebody that has a malady, or you yourself, you know, you have some kind of a malady, some disease, some kind of owie, ask this shaman or healer to show you in a practical example, you know, how he or she would heal this, you know, through you or through your asking. So we give this entity permission now to do whatever healing to choose now. Amen. And we ask to be shown, and we ask, you know, how the energies are being directed. Are there any energies projected? Where do the energies come from? Are the energies being sent through you? Okay, well, let's play around, and you can always go back later on and listen to this part again if you, kind of interrupted something, no harm done. Ask the shaman to step into the body, into your body. Let's imagine, you know, you do a healing on your, let's say, your partner, and so you imagine your partner being there, and of course we ask the partner or the high self in our spirit if he can do healing, if you have permission. If you don't have permission, just you know, see maybe yourself as receiving a healing, and but see yourself also as the healer there at the site. And now ask the shaman to step into that body, into your body there as the healer, and work through it, you know, sending the energy through it, moving the hands around to wherever it's needed, and also to show you, maybe in your inner vision, you know, what is wrong, you know, now. So you might be seeing some darkness, you know, some oily dark substance, some dark fluffy substance, so you might feel some ickiness, you know, ugh, or like ugh, vibration, you know, some of you are visible, some of you can just feel the quality of something like ugh. And some kind of feel it in the hand, like a tactile sensation. It's like heat or dense and clam, kind of, you know, there could be all kinds of sensations. Those sensations, they are not absolute, they're just like a pie chart on a computer, you know, giving you some kind of idea what is going on. It's not necessary that reality there looks like this, this is just a representation of reality. And we asked the shaman to maybe give instructions on how to improve our technique. And also let's arrange for, while the healing is going on, you know, this is on the astral or higher level, so people can multitask. And while the healing is going on, ask that there will be some kind of a system, you know, where you can call on the shaman, or where the shaman can call on you, so you kind of know when it's time to interact. It's like the telephone call. You know, this could be a sensation like your crown chakra opening or your heart opening or some visual coming into your mind, you know, or some mental thoughts coming into your mind, you know. So we ask that he shows, he, she shows you what kind of way to communicate now. Amen. And asked, you know, also what is the specialty of that shaman, you know, is this shaman more like a healer, or is this shaman more like a seer, you know, or communicator, you know, that gets, you know, the help of more powerful, maybe dimensional entities, higher dimensional entities, you know. And see what you're getting. And also ask there if there's other helpers, you know, that might want to work through you. You know, there can be totem animals. And if there are some, we ask them to step forward. And also there could be spirit guides, like not necessarily shaman type, you know, there could be wizard types, there could be, you know, wise woman type, there could be Atlantean magician type, there could be ET, high-tech. angels can work through you, totem animals can work through you. They all have their gifts, and ultimately, you know, it's God's power. So, I mean, you can ask Jesus to work through you, and you can ask God directly to work through you. You know, that is your personal preference, and also depends on the stage of your evolution. And now we ask, you know, it's maybe becomes time to finish this session, and we ask the inner shaman if it wants, he, she, it wants to communicate any messages to you. And if you have any questions, ask that questions now. And let's be open to the answer now. And we ask the shaman that, you know, the energy pathways be cleared, so that we become a more perfect tool for interfacing, you know, with this shaman, as long as it is, you know, a part of your soul evolution, you know, part of God's plan for you, or the plan that you chose for this lifetime. And to also remove any obstacles that are still there from past, like vows or any fears. Maybe you have been burned because you were a healer, you know, or ostracized from your tribe. Who knows? So there could be trauma from past life. You ask that it be removed. And that you always be guided for the highest good in divine harmony with the most benevolent outcomes. Amen. And now we say goodbye to the shaman and ask him to be around us whenever needed, and assist us and guide us whenever needed, but only for the highest good in divine harmony with the most benevolent outcomes. And now we say goodbye, the shaman leaves, and we, our cloud, our bubble turns into the cloud, and we float down, 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 straight into our bodies, down, 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 and it will count to 10, and when we are 10, you will be completely back in your body in present time. So one, you become gradually aware of your body again, and two, you become aware more of your surrounding, but keep your eyes closed, and three, your energy moves into your limbs, and four, you know, you can maybe move your toes and wiggle your hands a little bit, and five, you know, you will be able to remember everything that you saw, and even later on have more intuitions and insights in which you experience and maybe didn't realize at that time. And six, you become more aware of waking day consciousness. And seven, you become much more alert. And eight, your smell, your sense of your surroundings becomes more acute. And nine and ten, you're full at present time, snapped into your body now. Well, friends, how was it? I hope you had some good guided meditation. At least I hope you are relaxed. And I hope you got some insight and some connection. And I hope you become a light in this world. If you like this, maybe subscribe to the video. If you click on show more under the video, there are some links there. Let your friends know, watch all the other videos that I have. They cover a lot of tricks and tools on ascension, stuff that works, stuff I've done myself. I love you. Namaste.
Thank you. Thank you.